Hello, everybody. My name is Martin Miller. I'm from Microchip. And today I want to talk about 10BASE T1S, the new standard for Ethernet on a bus line. So let me give you a short agenda. I will start with an introduction of Microchip, then switch over and look into the technology, and finally look into the products which Microchip has to offer. So Microchip actually delivers many different connectivity solutions. We have Ethernet products, USB products, CAN, LIN, NOST, CoExpress, and the according security solutions. We have a long track record and expertise in networking. And we offer also total system solutions, which means not only the connectivity, also the microcontrollers and the tools and everything you need around. To give you an overview, Microchip is not only selling into automotive market, also industrial market plays a very important role for us. So we have a comprehensive Ethernet portfolio to support both markets, PHYs, switches, bridges, controllers, system on chips. And actually, we have a no end of life policy, which means as long as customers do buy our products, we will provide them. We will not end of life them. So that gives you a guarantee that you can use this product for a very long time. So no redesigns and requalifications necessary for you. So let me discuss a little bit about Ethernet in general. Why is Ethernet so important? In the past, we have had many different standards, LIN, CAN, FlexRay, MOST, and many more. And all those legacy networks are experts. They are the best fit for a dedicated task. So why should we switch to Ethernet? The reason is that Ethernet is a very good compromise to support all those requirements which you have. So you can have, for example, simple cabling, you can have a good arbitration protocol, and so on and so on. So many arguments to go for Ethernet, but in the past, when you had all the experts, you had to switch between different software stacks, between arbitration schemes, between different addressing schemes. So that was, you needed even an expert for each software development. You needed dedicated tools, and that makes the whole thing complex. If you look in the Ethernet area, you just have the PHY layer, and you might switch from one PHY to another PHY dependent on the network speed you need, and maybe on the physical layer if you want to use copper or optical transmission. But other than that, there is no change. And actually, you can feel the advantages today in your daily life. So when you use your laptop, it doesn't matter if you are connected via cable to the next switch, or if you're using wireless. And if both goes away, you use your mobile phone as a router, and you still can use all the applications. You don't need to change anything. Of course, this is impossible in the legacy way. If the CAN goes away, you cannot switch to a FlexRay connection or something like that. So you can really feel how good this works in your daily life. Also, the security mechanisms are available and well proven. So when you do your online banking, you can see the advantages of having excellent security mechanisms. So this is the reason why Ethernet has been so successful and has wiped away many transmission standards in the past. So if we go back 30 years, there were many network standards for IT. They are all gone away. Then the next area was in the telecom infrastructure. So we had ISDN, ATM, and all those standards. They are all history, and everything has been taken over by Ethernet. Now we can see this revolution taking place in industrial area. So RS-485, RS-232, all those standards are going away and are replaced by single-pair Ethernet. And last not least, I'm expecting that the same will happen in the automotive area too. So now let's look what's the special thing about 10 base T1S technology. Just to give you a brief overview what the technology provides, it's a 10 megabit connection. It's running in half duplex, which means only one can talk at a time. And you can use it either on a bus line as outlined here. So we have one cable and many are connected to the single cable. But of course you can only use two nodes and then get a point-to-point connection as well. And as mentioned, you can use it either on a UTP cable, but also you can use it on PCB if you have longer traces there. So that's pretty nice, and you can see already some advantages here in this system. For example, you don't need a switch, so you're saving a lot of money. If you would compare this to point-to-point connection, you would need much more cables. So there are many advantages from a hardware perspective, but of course also from a software perspective. Now, one very important element in 10Base T1S is something called PLCA. PLCA stands for Physical Layer Collision Avoidance. And it has been invented to solve a problem which we had in an old Ethernet standard, which also supported the bus line. And these are collisions. Collisions you get if multiple nodes on this bus line talk at the same time. So then the transmission is disturbed and all the information is lost. And this has the disadvantage that the overall bandwidth is decreasing, and also that you don't have a deterministic behavior. And this is, of course, important for safety-relevant applications, like in a car. So how do we get rid of the collisions? Actually, the mechanism is quite easy. We have one special node. It's the node with the ID 0. And this node sends out a beacon. A beacon is just a special symbol on the line. And if the beacon is seen by other nodes, then they know, okay, the transmission cycle is starting. So what is happening? Now, after the beacon, the node 0 is allowed to send its information. So it will start to send, and once it's done, there will be silence on the line. If there is silence for 2 bytes, which is a very short time actually, then node number 1 knows, okay, node number 0 is done, so I can start now. It will transmit. Once it's finished, there is silence on the line. So now node number 2 starts, and that goes on until all nodes have transmitted. And now the head node knows it has to send again a beacon to start the next transmission cycle. And with this simple mechanism, we get a lot of advantages. So first of all, we will always have 10 megabits, no matter what, independent from the number of nodes. And we will also have a fair distribution of the transmit opportunities amongst the participants in the network. So you can also calculate a maximum transmission cycle. So you know exactly how much time will there be at maximum until a node can send again. And you can all this use all this to calculate is the configuration as I have constructed it okay for my safety criteria. So that's a really important element. So this was the most technical slide. Now let me look a little bit into the automotive applications. So what we see in the moment is that the OEMs are investigating applications like ultrasonic and radar. You can see that here in this car, we have some sensors around the car, and they are connected to an ECU. And this ECU calculates the sensor results and the actions. So imagine if you would have this with a point-to-point connection, it would be very ugly. So you would need from this box a cable to each sensor dedicated. But also, let's say we have some special sensors here, front-looking radar or whatsoever, which maybe one customer buys and the other one not. You can see here the ECU always has only the two connections for this branches. So if I put more applications on my bus line, I don't need to change my ECU. So in other words, 10BASE-T1S increases the scalability of such solutions. Other applications are, for example, microphones. We can see a lot of microphone application in today's car. Hands-free, of course, is one important element, but also emergency calls. So if you are involved in an accident, you can use this to call for help, but also to sense the area around the car. Are there any kids playing, or what's going on? Is there maybe an ambulance? Or so this all can be detected by microphones and can help to increase the safety for the overall vehicle. Then we have powertrain applications. You might need to do some balancing of your batteries inside the car, or you need to control something inside your engine. Maybe you need to sense something in the gearbox, and so on and so on. So position, speed, pressure, temperature, all this kind of sensors are usually found in those applications. But we also see actuator applications, for example, light applications. You can use this technology to either control your lights, front lights, back lights, your indicators, but also the interior light, maybe some interior lights in the door or in the roof and ceiling of the car. So all this is possible. Then we will have also speakers in the car in future on 10BASE-T1S. So typically speakers are distributed. We have cars today with up to 20 speakers or even more. They are spread all over the car. And today you have a center device which is connecting all those speakers with a point-to-point connection. Of course, if you use a bus line, you can reduce the cabling here a lot. And I will show later how to even take further advantages. And this is not only for interior sound. We also have exterior sound in electric vehicles today. So when they are driving at a slow speed, you need to inform the outside of the car that a vehicle is driving around. So a car has to make some noise. And this is what we call exterior sound. But also for emergency calls, you might have a special speaker and so on. And last but not least, you have many motors in a car today to control the windows, the mirrors, to open the door, for pumps to control the windshield wiper and so on and so on. Of course, this cabling is only logic and not the real cabling. I will show later how it will look in reality. So you can see there are many applications. Actually, a lot of them have been on CAN in the past, but we expect that many of them will go over to 10BASE-T1S in future. Now, to show you a realistic cabling, we need to apply this modern approach how to architect a car. Typically, you have zones inside a car. And let me give you here the example of a door zone. Today, you already have an ECU in every door. So the ECU is controlling the windows, the mirrors, the lock, maybe also the access module to the car, and so on and so on. And you have many cables. You have some CAN cables going there. You have some LIN cables. So we expect that in future you will have one ECU, and it will only be connected via 10BASE-T1S and do everything which is needed inside the car, even the speaker. So this has a huge advantage. If you have a speaker inside the car, you can get rid of the heat problem in your center amplifier, because usually all the big speakers are in the doors. And if you can remove the drivers from those speakers out of the center device, then it only needs to drive some small speakers maybe here in the dashboard. And actually, then you can integrate that even in the head unit. So you're saving an ECU completely. But here also, you will control the light, the ambient light, everything. So one connection, and it controls everything. And this is a huge advantage, a great potential for saving money in cabling especially. We don't see only the door as a zone. There are many zones inside a car. You can, for example, see the bumpers as a zone to carry all the sensors. But also inside a seat, you have today many sensors. For example, is there somebody sitting? Maybe some vitality function. Is the person driving healthy? Or does the person need help? Do we have heating? What is the seat position? What about the seat belt, and so on? Maybe there are speakers in the headrest. Maybe there are microphones in the headrest. So many applications today in a modern seat, and they all can be controlled via a single cable. Also inside the roof, you have the ambient light, you have the microphones, you have the antenna applications, then the engine compartment with all the sensors and actuators, the battery for battery management, and there are many more. So let me now talk a little bit about the products we have in Microchip to support you in your 10BASE-T1S development. So we can offer you today a bunch of boards to kickstart your development. Let me start here with the first one. It's a 10BASE-T1S PHY, which can be accessed via RMI or MRI. So that fits to many applications. We have this classical adapters. So you can use them on almost every microcontroller board, but also on many others too. They have a very small form factor, and they have everything to support the 10BASE-T1S. So what you usually do is you take a microcontroller which has a MAC, and you connect this little board, and then you get from us some driver. So you configure the PHY, and then you have your Ethernet connection, and that's all you need. Nothing special, no special software on top. So that makes it really easy, and you can benefit from all the software you already have on those boards. Just to give you an impression of the connector we are using, so we decided to use only a clamp connector and not take anything special that makes it easy for you. You can take any kind of cable. You can easily go from one node to the next node. So I think that makes the cabling really easy for you. We also have the same board as we show here with RMI, with MRI. maybe you know this connector. It's on many older switches. It's on many PCI cards. So we have provided this board for compatibility also on tools. You find it sometimes. So I think you usually won't use this in a development because this is a very clumsy connector. But if you have old equipment, you can use it and connect and immediately reuse this. And therefore, we have developed also this board. Another board we have is a USB to 10Base T1S bridge. So you can use this board and connect it into your laptop, into your Raspberry Pi or whatsoever. You get some drivers for us for Windows and Linux, and you install it, and you immediately have a new Ethernet adapter in your system, which supports 10Base T1S. And that means, of course, you can now use VLC to stream audio and video. You can use Wireshark to do any kind of analysis on the network. So it's a pretty easy way to get everything hooked up in seconds. If you buy a few of those, you can build an impressive demonstrator within one afternoon. And last not least, we also have some software samples and also a driver suite provided our MPLAB Harmony. And yeah, you can use this on our microchip controllers, and that speeds up your software development on those controllers. We will also provide, we are also to, able to sample the parts which are built here, the files with the different interfaces in the moment only under NDA, but we expect that in summer we will also offer this late summer over our webpage. Finally, I want to show you an implementation example, how we have taken those boards and built a demonstrator. So we take a standard microchip evaluation board for a SAMe54 microcontroller. We took a click board with a sensor, so you can buy thousands of them on Amazon or wherever, with all kind of sensors. We bought one for temperature, pressure, and humidity. And then finally, we took our RMI board and connected it over this connector and installed our driver on the MCU. And then we took a Raspberry Pi, connected a display and a 10Base T1S USB bridge. And now we can transmit the results, which we collected here from the sensors, over to the Raspberry Pi and run a little GUI to show the values, and you can see here the change of values. So that's pretty easy to build. That this kind of demos you can build in very short time. All right, and this concludes my presentation. If you have any questions, I'm happy to take them. Thank you for your interest.